Hello people and welcome to a brand new game. Well, sort of brand new anyways. This is I Am Alive for PC and I will be your host today, Duke. Let's see here. Yes, I want to start a new game. On normal, of course. Yeah, I know I don't get more retries. This is a very special game. It was developed by Ubisoft. And for a Ubisoft PC release, it's actually very good because it does not have the fucking DRM system. I love it. Anyways, let's watch the intro here so we can get in the mood, as I would say. I will go through what the game is about in a while, after this little cutscene here. You know what? The sound is really, really, really low. You know what? We're going to skip this cutscene because it's way too fucking quiet. I don't know what sound it runs on, but it might be the music sound, in which case, yeah, it's going to be very, very low. I will try and up the volume on those later on, but for now we will just focus on playing here. Now you will see that it says map updated, press Y. That's because I'm playing with my Xbox controller. When I originally played this game, it was for the Xbox, so that's the controls I've gotten used to. So, using that, live with it. If nothing else, you do not have to hear my mouse clicks for once, which is a fun thing, right?
In traffic. Oh, no, I missed it.
Oh, yes. City traffic. So much fun. Yup. Here we go. Now, this game is a lot of... it involves a lot of parkour, as we will see here. Or, well, climbing, to begin with. At the top of the screen, you can see a little red bar and a white bar. The white bar is our stamina. As we are climbing, it is decreasing. When the stamina runs out, we will start losing stamina capacity. When stamina capacity reaches zero, we basically fall to our death. Which is always fun, right? We will try and keep on here. And make sure we get up here to rest a bit. Much better. Now we're just gonna walk a bit here. Yeah, we're gonna rush a bit here. Yada yada yada, and we're gonna drop down. And keep climbing. Yeah, so parts of this game is a lot about climbing. Being able to efficiently manage your stamina and the things that come with it. You will see more of that part later, but for now, all you have to know is that there is stamina and you don't want to run out of it. You can see here that we could walk out on this pole here and jump. Hang on this ledge a bit and climb up. Alright, more climbing.
You have to climb over those arch supports.
Yes, exactly. Now, I've completely forgotten our character's name, so I will simply call him Our Guy for now. As you can see there, climbing, or well, jumping whilst climbing, uses up a lot of stamina. It's not something you should do too much. Climb up here a bit. Rest for a second. Go down the ledge and start climbing again. Yeah, so if you jump like that, you can reach things that are a bit further away, but like you saw, it drains quite a bit of stamina, so it's not something you want to do. Stamina burns as you climb. Try to apply it correctly. I think I actually accidentally jumped there. Not good. Because we are probably gonna run out of stamina on this part. Do not fear, even if we lose our stamina capacity, there are still things we can do. Like I said, when our stamina runs out, we have to... Yeah, we have no more stamina. Put some extra effort into it. So right now, our guy is fighting for his dear life to hang on to this ledge, which is a clever move, because if he didn't, he'd fall down and die. For me, extreme effort burns your stamina capacity. Now, we have an inventory. In this inventory, currently we have some a food can and some water. Water gives us 1 plus in 1 plus in stamina capacity and 1 stamina. we drink that, we gain almost all our stamina back. Almost. But for now, it's really enough for us.
Well, it's still standing. Though Abington has seen better days.
I bet it has. Anyways, as you can see here, the world's kind of shit. We will gain more info on that later. For now, all I can say is there has been an event on the world, which have caused severe... I mean, the thing is basically called the event. There's been severe earthquakes, and there's basically dust everywhere. Dust is not something good. Let's just say that. Dust is very, very bad. If you inhale it, you die. Or at least over a prolonged period of time, you die. We're going to get more into that later, because we're going to have to move through the dust on several occasions. Anyways, let's perform some more dangerous climbing. Climb hand over hand. Oh, you're so buffed. Show off. Whatever, let's see here. I've completely forgotten to... Do what? Time my recording! Like always. So, this has gone maybe 10 minutes at max. This is gonna be an introduction video, so it's not gonna be too long. So I'm gonna... 5 minutes from now. Yeah, that's about right. We'll stop and then we'll start a new one. The thing is, this game does not run on saves, unlike Vampire or the other games I play. It runs on checkpoints because it is a console game after all, so... I'm gonna try to record 1 hour, but I'm then gonna have to... When that hour hits, I will find the next checkpoint and then I will basically quit for the day. That's how I'm going to do it. Or at least try to do it. So each episode is going to be 15 minutes. Around. This one is obviously not gonna be 15 minutes. Maybe 10. I don't know. This might even be 20 minutes. I really don't think so. I think I would be able to forget for that long. Jump. Run faster. Jump again. Running like that when you know you're gonna have to climb is a really bad idea, but I have played this first part a good amount of times, so I do know what we will be climbing and where. Anyways, let's go down a bit. Now you might see that there's a way we could get over there. And if we move an angle slope like this, slide! That was perhaps the most pathetic slide in the entire game. We will find much more interesting and a lot more fun parts involving that later. But for now, let's just focus on climbing here. Jump over. Climb up again. Recover. It's not that high. It is a bit far, however.
I can probably get back up to the streets if I go through the sewer.
Ah yes, every game has to have sewers. I love sewers. I love dead people. Anyways, you would have heard a bit more about the game if I would have shown you the intro, but you know, I'll rectify that later on. But for now, this is what you're going to do. Anyways, we can see our map here. It's one of the things it goes through if you have watched the trailers and such. Always have a map, one that you can fold and draw on. Because as we move about in the city, things aren't going to look like they are here. The streets, all streets aren't going to be open, all buildings aren't going to be standing. So, you know, we're going to be able to draw it out on the map ourselves. Well, the dude draws for us, which is very handy. Anyways, let's keep moving.
What's that? Hey, you!
He got a gun.
Trouble. I'm already gone.
Let's just back off. He doesn't have anything we want, and we don't really have any way of fighting him. We have a pistol, but he doesn't have any ammo. Anyways, this is our world now.
There's a lot of dust down there. Pretty thick.
Yeah. Let's just say, if we don't die from the fall, we will not be able to breathe, and then we will die that way instead. Oh, shut up, I can run wherever the fuck I want. I've already gone out of your sewer, just shut up. You can keep your hole in the ground, I don't want it. Nor could I take it even if I wanted to. Because all we have with us is basically our backpack, some climbing rope, that food can, and our pistol. Which our man has never actually fired. Anyways, we're going to go to our apartment over here to find our family. Our wife and kid. We've gone all across America to get right to here, and... well, how many of you actually think we're gonna find them when we get there? The game would be way too easy if it was like that. Don't be naive. Of course we ain't gonna find them. As you can see, in this game you do not have... retries are basically extra lives. When you die, you have to use a retry from the nearest checkpoint. As you can see here, there's a gigantic pit here. Well, not gigantic, but it's probably high enough to kill us. Keep that in mind. Here's a gate. It's got barbed wire all over it.
Could force open this gate with something.
Yes, sadly, we don't have that something.
Hey, you.
However,
you.
This guy does have something.
Step back.
Now, you might remember that our gun does not actually have any bullets.
Shit.
However, this guy doesn't know that. Goodbye. Anyway, that was your quick little intro to the
what the
developers call the intimidation close combat system. Basically, I mean, we have a gun, and a gun is quite overall intimidating, and as long as we pretend the gun is full, our enemies are probably gonna think it is, in which case they'll be our bitch. Now, we also have a machete for close combat, and well, also for busting up blocks and like this. Fine, shut the hell up. Anyways, that will be our first intro. You've seen a bit of the game and all of that, and now we're gonna get into a little more action. See you soon.